Hello, everybody. Been a minute. So, for those of you wondering and wanting an update on the lives of Dark Rose Manor, let this serve. What can we tell ya? It's been a hell of a year already. 2015. First week of June, almost summer. The sun refuseth to shine. Yep, that's where the stage was. Now it's just one big patch of dead grass. But the mulch is back. The weeds are gone. The haunt is gone, the Bardo area is trying to grow back, things are blooming and looking pretty again. Speaking of pretty, Duncan, a little worse for the wear, but still up. We'll come back to the Duncan portion of the conversation momentarily. But yes, green, it's probably all this rain. There's the sun. Well, this could almost be a night shot. Yes, warmth and sunshine. Not so much this year. So, where does Dark Rose Manor stand currently? Well, we're still planning to take the year off. But, on the bright side, what can we tell you? We've been invited to be special guests for our anniversary this year by a very special group of professional haunters. We think that's cool. We're not going to mention names or drop names. We're not going to do that. We are very humbled and honored to be invited to be special guests. Alright, that's probably more hint than anybody needed. We think it's nice that we have professional haunter friends and home haunter friends. Speaking of home haunter friends, there is a home haunt here in Colorado that has also invited us to be special actor trainers. That could be interesting. Just out of the blue, reaching out to Dark Rose Manor about a week ago. We think that's pretty cool. River. Not quite Demon Dog. Yeah, right. We'll get back to River in a minute.
Monster of mischief.
Yeah, right. And also on the Dark Rose Manor front, we think it's interesting to mention that some television producers that have, again, not so much at liberty to discuss this, but some very special television producers that are working on a show that you all maybe heard of before has also reached out to Dark Rose Manor and mentioned that they might like us to be special guests. Dark Rose Manor is still alive and well, and in its own right, doing pretty well.
We also have a very special guest arriving next week. We'll be
yes,
with us for 10 days.
Do.
Mr. Damian Michael, Halloween Nut himself, is coming to stay here with us at DRM, which will be interesting and fun. We'll be vlogging that for sure.
I think we even had discussions of the dueling vlogs. So, yes, we will capture that and share it with the world in our own way. As you know, the Roses have taken a bit of a break from Facebook. We're dealing with some personal things, but we're doing okay. And I know some of you would like to know how we're doing, and that's what we'll say, that we're doing okay. We've got each other. We have passion and heart.
We have brain juice.
We have brain juice. Brain juice!
Oh, and this week, which was really great, my Aunt Linda on my father's side, who I guess I was about 3 years old the last time I saw her, so technically I've never met her, and my Uncle Don, her husband, and my cousin Evie made a special trip here to visit with me and Mama Rose. It was a lot of fun. It was kind of cool.
Yay, Aunt Linda! Maker of awesome new family heirloom quilt. Fan of Dark Rose Manor. Yay. I sadly missed that. I was at work. But it was good to have guests at the manor. We haven't had very many guests lately, but that's okay.
You're wonderfully tolerant of our mess, too.
Yes, yes. The mess. It's been a mess. You can see some of the lumber and some of the props still standing, but we're slowly bringing it back. Look at that pretty mulch. Yes. It is still amazing to see all the haunt down where once there was a carnival. But we still have cardinals. They're out there. Virgil over there. Like I said, Duncan. Speaking of Duncan, speaking of personal problems, here's some funnies that even these trees are part of. Among our personal problems, or during these, I find it funny to note that our wonderfully hypocritical evangelical neighbor,
the one that thinks that we're Satanists.
Yes, the one that thinks we're Satanists, decided to call the city on us and have us cited for our big overgrown dying trees, despite the fact that she's fully aware of some of our problems currently. So yes, thank you for calling the city on us. No, yes, there's always an upside. That actually also works with haunts. Small world.
These trees, we're going to take them down only as far as we have to. And then he's going to carve skull and demon faces into the two on the outside, like totem poles. Pointing this direction, of course, to make sure that she can see.
Yes.
And then the center one here, I'm gonna have him carve
the
DRM logo into it.
Hell yeah. Now here's a little tip for those of you that would like to call the city and remain anonymous. If you'd like to turn your neighbors in and remain anonymous, do not go into such great intricate detail about the things going on in their backyard that no one else would know about. And then make sure that the people that you're contacting at the city have not previously heard of us, which they have. It's like, oh, you're calling us about the haunted house in your neighborhood. Well, that's good. Fortunately, the city is still very kind to us. But we do have to deal with our trees now. Yay. And yes, Duncan was mentioned as part of her complaint. Notice he's still there. Yes, he's there for now. I have to take him down and repair him because he's in sore need of some tender loving care. So yes, all the rain, all the hail, roof is damaged, skylight is damaged. Thank God the restoration people that the insurance company won't cover ripped our master bathroom wall and ceiling to shreds and then had to go away because insurance wouldn't cover it, so I'll have to deal with that myself. But I can do that. I'm a haunter. She's a haunter. I'm sure we can drywall the stupid bathroom again. We can handle that.
It's all ridiculously dangerously humorous now.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
it's funny. It's not even drama to me anymore.
Or even stress. It's just like, you know what? You know what they call this? A life. And if you can't laugh at your problems, then, well, your problems beat you. And we're not going to be beaten by some problems. Problems are merely things to overcome. Problems are merely things to develop solutions. And who better than a haunter to come up with a solution? Now there's River. Not only is she one of the problems, she has more problems than we know what to do with. Poor thing. 6 months old. Ain't even 30 damn pounds. But we love her. She's still around and we're doing our best. What else can we tell you? Looking less and less likely that the crew of the Lilliputeer is going to even be able to make a single voyage to the Renaissance Festival this year. Oh well, neither here nor there, I guess. Yeah. Pandora stalking River, waiting for her to do something stupid so she can squirt her with the water gun. Alright, well, yeah, as Pandora would say, there you have it. The roses are okay. The passion in the heart of DRM is alive and well. Check in again.
Until the first light.